Hi, Jeff Lawton here, and I'm going to take you on a tour of our neighbour's property here at the Green in the Desert site in Jordan in the Dead Sea Valley, 400 metres below sea level. Abla, our student, took the course a year ago. Just here is her property, and you can see the comparison next door. Let me show you what's happened in just under a year. Okay, let me just give you a comparison of what the property was like. It's just solid rock and loose rocks and pretty poor soil. But when you come through over into the garden, immediately you start to see a lush change. We've got climbers going up, little trellised strings and wires, gonna create a lot of shade later. This is actually the back garden, and Abla's used a lot of compost. She's got herbs and vegetables dotted around, even around a large rock that's still in position here, of course. She's worked around the features. She's got lots of clumping basil and some nice ground covers as well. There's Ethiopian cabbage there and young olive trees. And she just created a really comfortable space. There's our worm farm, dripping worm juice every day. And worm castings being able to be used as fertilizer. And here we've got a lovely little seeding space on the western side. And it is shaded with a shade cloth. There's the setting sun in the background through the shade cloth. But this area is quite comfortable. There's an unglazed earthen pot sitting in the garden, which is evaporating off through the unglazed surface. And then from here, you can look down into the garden with the Green in the Desert site in the background. And with all this biological material creating shade, creating cover, creating mulch, reducing evaporation, reducing the wind, increasing the amount of water in the ground that can be retained and soaked. There's lots of support species. There's nice poncianas and albizilla becks and leucina and sesbania. And here's some eggplant and some marshmallow plant, which is a common herb here. And there's little cassias and beautiful fast-growing moringas. And Abla's making a earth-filled plastic bottle wall here. So she's recycling plastic bottles and filling them with soil. In fact, she's getting the little kids to do it. And then she's going to render the wall like an earthship-type structure, but an earthship recycled earth-filled bottle wall, whatever that comes to. And then further down, the grey water goes into a top swale terrace. And down there, she's got a young banana in, I can see now. She's got moringa and she's got eggplant. And there's eggplant producing, even at this time, at the end of summer. So it's a lush little garden. But let me take you just round the corner here. She's obviously used a lot of rock. There's no shortage of rock here. It's a resource that's abundant. And then just around here, in the backside of the house, she's got this little appropriate nursery. And she's shading it with climbing vines. And we have climbing vines going right across the nursery. And some little recycled shelving. So from the back garden to the eastern garden, we have a nicely shaded little spot where we can propagate seedlings. And then we come out and look down on the garden. It's a very beautiful space. And all of this has grown in just 11 months. This was bare soil. In fact, our last permaculture design course, we used this site for the design exercise. So she got some good ideas from all her fellow students. Beautiful rock wall here, dry stone rock wall that she's made herself just by piling up rocks. Nice bougainvillea. And she's going to extend the rock wall up through those recycled wooden pallets, she tells me. She's brought in one or two date palms now. So they've been transplanted at a larger size just to speed up the production, and they're beautiful features. So this is one lady working all on her own. She's a retired school teacher. And here we have all kinds of combinations of support species. Tachoma stands, there's a nice bushy-topped neem there. There's an Australian acacia, leucina, casuarina, albizilla beck. And she's got her support species rampantly planted. Over on this side, there's a whole combination. And she's gradually bringing in the fruit trees because she's learnt in the permaculture course that in this hard ground, you got to specialise in improving the soil quality first bring in the support species to support and shelter your fruit trees. And as they become established, then you can start planting the productive trees. I can see here, she's got a little peach just in here. So there's a peach very nicely sheltered in amongst Leucaena and Ponciana and Albizia Lebec. There's a small guava here next to the sugar cane. And I can see here, there's a bit of a pumpkin vine taken off. So all of this, this beautiful little garden, all been done by one lady, more or less semi-retired, doing regular hand tool work. You can see there, she's got a wheelbarrow full of tools, working with hand tools all the time. And here's a recycled water tank. And in there, she's got a sieve compost. Compost she's regularly making. This garden will be completely shaded, very low water demand in the end, and very, very productive. And a beautiful place to be. She's got a recycled chicken pen at the moment. It's this recycled material. And here they are. She's got some beautiful local birds. A kind of Ancona type colouring with a Hamburg tail, and I would say English game type of small size, but that's what the local people seem to be using. Small size birds, quite long and leggy, obviously resist the heat, and seem to do very well and get reasonably good eggs. Here's a compost pile, and it's quite a compost pile, doing pretty well. And then over here, a shade house. It's got quite a few plants in too. And she's got this quite exotic looking shade house, quite an icon of the area now. And there we go. Got the comparison on both sides. That was what it was like before. So there you go. Abla's little urban garden in a very dry, hostile, hot desert situation. In just 12 months, one lady, one permaculture design certificate course, more or less, game over.